honor and respect. This is Ancista Brujo Luis, and I know I haven't done a video in a long time, so I just want to take a few moments to say thank you to everybody. Hello, everybody. I've been busy. It's summertime, and so it's been hard for me to do videos, as I am a working brujo. And I do have clients, and I have future plans, which I'm hoping to get these done, hopefully by the end of the year. But I just wanted to do this video real quick to say thank you to all my new subscribers. We're going into 15,000. I humbly, from the bottom of my heart, say thank you, mucha gracias. I really appreciate it. I wasn't gonna do a video, but I have like half hour before my next client comes in. So I just wanted to reach out and say thank you. I'm still here. I haven't forgotten about you. Summer times are a little bit busy. And you know, I'm a father, I'm a partner, I'm a son, I'm a piritista, un brujo, have my clients. So juggling all that and trying to get a video in for you guys sometimes can get a little bit hard, but understand that I'm always thinking about my YouTube, and I haven't forgotten about you. So I'm just letting you know, thank you to all my new subscribers. I hope you enjoy the channel. Watch old videos, hopefully you like them, share them. And anyways, I'm just gonna show you a little trabajo that I do, because I'm not gonna just do a video and not do something. So I'm gonna do something simple that I wanna share with you guys before I cut off, because you know, clients will be coming in pretty soon. So I'm gonna do that real quick, but I just wanna say thank you to the new subscribers, and I'm just gonna get into what this video is about. So I didn't wanna just do a video, you know, just to say hello and then walk away without, you know, giving you a trabajito. So I have this charcoal in my hand, which I'm gonna light, because this is gonna be part of my trabajo. And I'm gonna light it up, and I have scissors. I can't find my charcoal lighting thing. So I'm gonna light this up because this is gonna be part of the video of what I'm gonna be talking about today. So I wanna make sure that this carbon, this charcoal, incense charcoal, you don't want to use the charcoal that you use to cook outside. You want to use the charcoals that you use for incenses and for all that. So I'm going to get this charcoal nice and lit, and then get into what my video is of for today. I have my incense burner ready, and make sure this burns up nice for what the video is about today. So I was in a client's house where, you know, the person had moved into a new place, and she wanted to cleanse the house of vibrations and all that, and you know, she had just moved in. And I said, you know, let's cleanse the house, let's purify the house. And she said, you know, I don't have no sage. I said, honey, you don't need sage, we're Puerto Rican, somos boricua, you don't need sage, you know. There's a lot of things you can use, you don't always have to use sage. So I said, mama, just get me una cebollita, an onion, get me garlic. Ajo. We always have cebolla and ajo in the house. Puerto Ricans, we always use this. This is a staple in our food. And I told her, Puerto Ricans, especially espiritistas, never throw away the garlic skin or the onion skin. I'm going to show you what I'm talking about. This is a garlic, ajo. And we try to save the garlic skin, because the garlic skin can be used for removing negative vibrations from the home, for cleansing the home from thought forms, energy, depression. It also, both onion, I know garlic is ruled by Mars, fiery energy. Not sure if onion is, I can't remember right now, but I know garlic is. So they're good for removing negative energy, psychic dirt, energy that may be absorbed in the walls of the house. Because, you know, we do clean the house, but, you know, physically, you know, with Windex and all that. But you got to clean the house. You got to make sure your house is purified. And not always you need sage. You can use agua florida and incenses and prayers and all that. So I told her, don't throw away your garlic skin and don't throw away your onion skins. Very good for cleansing, for removing And I always use them because when I do sesiones espiritistas, sesiones veladas espirituales, after everyone leaves the house or the reunion, reuniones espirituales, I like to cleanse the house, my house. And what I do is I save my garlic skins and my, so here, this is garlic skin. I like to cleanse the house, and what I do is I actually just put it on charcoal. Just put it on charcoal. It's lit. So I put it on the charcoal and start throwing off that smoke. See that smoke right there? That's what I want. And what I do is I cleanse around the house. If a person, just putting this garlic skin on the charcoal. I don't know if you can hear it crackling, but it burns really good. Okay, this is very strong. It's not a sweet smelling scent, so don't expect that. Wish I had prepared, and I'm gonna use some onion skin because they both great for removing negative energies from the house. The best thing to do is you could just place the skin of the garlic on the charcoal, or you can just powder it down. I should have just powdered it down. Put it up, there you go. Powder it down, pass it around the house, cleanse the house, remove all that negative vibration that you do not want within your house. Some onion and garlic skin in my hand. What I'm going to do is I'm going to crush it up in my hand. Just really crush it up. I think the burn, it definitely burned much easier that way. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to place it on. Now I'm going to place it on, and I'm doing it in my hand. Now I'm going to use that and place it on the charcoal. And this will burn much better. This is good for removing the evil eye, removing negative energies from the house. Depression doesn't smell good. It smells like garlic and onion, okay? So whenever you use garlic and onion to purify, to cleanse, it's also good to cleanse someone who has negative vibrations on them, whether it be the evil eye, envidia, mal de ojo, whatever it may be. You can take this and you can pass it over a person's aura to cleanse the person, okay? Whenever you use garlic and onion to remove a negative vibration or a thought form or anything in the house, you also want to burn, after you have completed this, you want to burn something sweet, whether you burn frankincense, whether you use frankincense, nag champa, anything sweet. But when you remove, you want to attract now something positive into the house. So what the garlic skin and the onion smoke does is remove, okay? While you want to attract something positive. So when this is finished, okay, then you also do that. Pass it by the doors of the house, the windows of the house, every window of the house. A lot of brujos, they do hang garlic cloves by the windows or by the doorways to absorb negative vibration. And by burning the skins, believe it or not, they're really good. It burns really good. It's really good for cleansing the home, the doorways, the windows, especially if someone comes into your house that gives you anxiety or brings negative vibrations into the home. You don't want that in your house. Then you just take some of that garlic skin and some of that onion skin and burn it. Afuera. Sacúdete, sacúdete, sacúdete. Another trabajo or spiritual work that I know a lot of Latinos use, especially with the garlic, is you can use the garlic itself, okay? Now, you know that we place garlic on the doorways to absorb negative energies, but you want to take, you want to peel off, and you want to get 12 of the outer, at least, what do you call this? So you peel this off, and you want 12 of these. You don't have to crush it up. 12 of the dientes is what we call them in Spanish, but you want 12 of these. You don't have to crush it up. You want to peel off the skin, because you want to save the skin for an incense. But when you're feeling like there's, like if you're depressed, if you feel there's negative vibrations around you, you feel weak, you feel disorientated, you feel like you're under psychic attack, maybe someone's giving you el mal de ojo, la mala lengua, bochinche, chisme, gossip, you're going to take 12 cloves. Now you want to do this at night because it's not going to smell pretty good, but you're going to take 12 cloves and you're going to boil it in a quart of water. You don't have to crush it up, just boil 12 cloves. Let that cool down, strain the water, and when the water's cool, strain it, mix it with a can of beer. Any beer that you like is good, cerveza, and go into the, this is at night, you're gonna do this at night because you're gonna, you don't wanna go outside after that. You wanna take this solution of garlic water and cerveza, beer, and you're gonna pour it over your head and you're gonna pray. You're gonna pray any psalm that you want to remove negative vibrations, any psalm to calm you down, any prayer. There's a prayer in Spanish, para el santo del ajo, if you wanna pray that. If you're Hispanic and you know that prayer, then you can use that prayer. But you wanna visualize that this is removing, this is cleansing yourself. After this bath, you're not gonna smell pretty good, so you know, let it, you know, dry off real, you know, just naturally. Put some white clothing on and go to sleep, do your prayers. But when you're pouring this over your head and you're praying, visualize that all this negative vibration is removing itself from your body and down into the drain. So do that. Another thing that we do, and there's many jobs, there's many trabajos with the ajo, but you want to do it with 12 dientes of the ajo and make sure you save your skins. Another thing with the onion, a lot of espiritistas and brujos and curanderas would do this with the onion, especially if someone is sick. In the sick room, you want to cut an onion and you want to place the onion, you can cut it any way you want, you want to place it on a plate and you want to place it by the bed of the person who is sick. It could be materially sick, physically sick, or spiritually sick. The onion will absorb bacteria, and not just bacteria, it could also absorb negative vibrations from the person. So you want to peel the onion and you want to cut it and you want to put it in a plate and put it next to the bed of the person who may be sick, as the onion will absorb any bacteria, any negative vibration. Now these are folk traditions that we do in Puerto Rico and in many Latin American countries, and a lot of them do that. So you can use la cebolla to cleanse, to purify, to absorb negative vibration, especially negative vibrations from mal de ojo, evil eye, mala lengua, bochinche, chismes. Okay? Garlic is also used, el ajo, is also used to attract money. And sometimes, you know, if a person plays bingo, or legitimately it attracts money and attracts good luck and all that. So usually a reguardo is prepared for a client, and it really is either a red or a green bag. All I happen to have is black bags. But you know, el brujo, it takes 3 garlic cloves and they place it into un reguardito, una bolsita, you know, and they prepare it, they bless it, they add smoke to it. Okay, so they give this to the client. This is prepared, this is blessed, this is, you know, each brujo does it differently. They fumigate it and they charge it to attract money, especially if the person is playing bingo or lottery or whatever it may be, but as a charm to attract. It could be used in a little black bag, or you can take garlic and place it. This is not a purse. I'm going to pretend it's a purse. You can take this little charm bag and place it into your purse. Keep it in your purse to attract good luck. And you just want to keep it there for the cycle of a full moon, okay? No more than that. I wouldn't keep that. Usually, it's not a charm bag that you want to keep forever. It's just the cycle of a full moon, so it's pretty much 1 month. Onions, el ajo, if someone is throwing evil eye or envidia to your property, to your home, a lot of times a person will cut una cebolla, pray over the cebolla, bless the cebolla, the onion, and take the part where it's wet, and they will pass it over the doorway of the house. So, you know, both the inside and the outsides of the house. And also, I knew a person who purchased a new car and, you know, wanted to make sure that no one gave the car an evil eye. So what the person did is they cut the onions and they blessed the wheels of the car, literally the four wheels, lo cuatro, and they invoke lo cuatro ángeles, San Miguel, San Rafael, San Gabriel, San Uriel, to protect and defend the car. But yeah, you can use the onion to protect, to defend, to watch over. They are both ruled, both garlic, and this is all messed up, I opened it, both the garlic, el ajo, garlic, cebolla, onion, are masculine energies, ruled by Mars, so they have Mars quality. And so yeah, that's what pretty much they're used for. There's a lot of different folk ways of using both el ajo and the garlic. So I just wanted to include this in the video as well, just a little, you know, to show you that I'm still here. I want to add that if you like this video and you want to see more videos of witchery in the kitchen, brujiendo en la cocina, and items that you can use in the kitchen, just leave a message down below if you're interested in these kind of videos, and I will keep adding more of these videos of common items that you can find in the house and how to use them in your spiritual or magical workings, tu trabajo espirituales, tu trabajo mágicos. So if you like this video and if you enjoyed it, you know, just leave a comment down below and say, you know, I like that. What other items can we use in the kitchen? And if people like this video, then I'll do more on that in the future. My advice to you as an espiritista, as a brujo, is never throw away your garlic skin and your onion skins. You can use it for protection, for removing the evil eye, negative vibrations, negative thought forms. You can also add it into incenses that are used for that. You can, you know, use it to attract money. Okay, the skin is used to attract money. Many espiritistas, we cut onions and we use not just onions but also garlic to absorb witchcraft from a person's body. It doesn't smell good, but it does, you know. We cut the onion and the onion, like the egg, absorbs la brujería, la envidia, mal de ojo, all these negative things. So I always tell people, you know, there's a lot of things. If you don't have sage in your house, you know, Palo Santo, because everyone's using sage and Palo Santo, olvídate de eso, forget about that. Use some garlic skin. Trust me, it works real good. This is something that a lot of espiritistas in Puerto Rico, they use in templos and in centros to cleanse, to purify, to remove negative vibrations. I keep saying the same thing over and over. Also good to attract money, to attract business. Whenever you burn onion and charcoal, I'm sorry, onion and ajo, garlic skins, after it comes completely burns down and it removes, burn a sweet smelling incense to attract what you want into the house. I hope you enjoyed this video. It's very short. I just want to do a video to let people know that I'm still here. I've been busy. I wish I can do more videos. Summertime is very busy for me, but I'm still here thinking about you. Thank you to the new subscribers. I really appreciate that from the bottom of my heart. I hope you enjoy my channel. And please share it with your friends and your whoever you think might enjoy the channel. And I will be doing future videos, you know, because I like to, you know, teach, you know, simple things that are good to learn, you know, that people, I think, brujos, espiritistas, curanderos, these traditions that are part of the Latin American culture. I like to share that, you know. I can't share everything, but I try to share, you know, the things that most common people should know. So, closing the video, save your garlic skin, onion skin, and your garlic skin, your cebolla, and your ajo. Go for protection, go for cleansing, go for removing, and good to absorb. Absorb and also attract dinero, money, la plata. This is Sancita Brujo Luis. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, please hit that like button. Please leave a comment down below. Please subscribe. Please share. Much respects. I'm still here. Sorry I don't do as many videos as I usually do. Summertime is a little busy, but I'm going to be back, and I have future projects that I need to get done before the ending of the year. Anyways, this is Sancista Brujo Luis. I hope you enjoyed the video, and if you did, like I said, please hit that like button. Please subscribe. Much love, much respects. Sancista Brujo Luis. Está bien lindo.
Ah, pero no se ve. El sauce.